on Game Night, Nikki, Lincoln, Rusty, and myself, Dave, are going to play Imhotep, Builder of Egypt, a game for 2 to 4 players, published by Kosmos and designed by Phil Walker Harding. So let's move some stones, man.
Hey, Dave.
Let me guess. Would you like me to teach you Imhotep?
That is correct.
All right. Imhotep is a really simple game, actually, in which you only have one thing to do every turn from a list of things. The meat of the game comes essentially in how things get scored. The game takes place in 6 rounds. The beginning of every round, we're going to turn over one of these 7 cards. I say that very pointedly because the first time I played that, we forgot the game took 6 rounds, and so we ended up playing 7 rounds. So the easiest thing to do with these cards is to shuffle them and then just remove one. These cards have 4 boats on them. In this case, a 3, a 3, a 3, and a 2. So we'll just pull those out from... No, they don't go there yet.
Okay.
We haven't sailed. Every one of these cards will have...
Right.
Every one of these cards will have 4 boats on them. And we are using the cards for a 4-player game. That's why it has a little thing on the top. There are card sets not in use for a 3-player game and a 2-player game. Let me put those over here to the side. And on your turn, you can do one of 4 things. The first thing you can do is you can take a stone from your sled. This is called your sled. And you can place it on any available space on one of the boats. It can be any space. You can place here at the beginning of the boat, or if you want, at the end of the boat, or in the middle of the boat. And why you might want to place in one over the other will become clear later in the explanation. So that's one thing you can do. Place a stone from your sled to the boat. Second thing you can do is you can take 3 stones from the quarry and move them to your sled. If you do not have enough spaces to move 3 stones to your sled, for example, I only have 1 space, whereas Lincoln has 3 available spaces. This is because we randomly determined Lincoln to be the start player. He will start with 2 stones, Rusty with 3, I with 4, and Nikki with full 5. So if Lincoln were to do the 3 stones action, he would take 3 stones and put them on our sled. If you or I did that, Rusty, we would take just as many as we needed to fill the sled to 5, and that would be the whole thing. So for me, it would only get me 1 stone. But it might be a way I could pass tempo-wise instead of, say, doing one of the other things. So that's the second thing you can do on your turn. A third thing you can do on your turn is you can sail one of these boats to one of these sites. Each site has a little notched port where a boat can fit. Each site can only take 1 boat per round, so once a boat sails to one of these sites, another boat cannot sail to that site this round until we clear everything and flip over a new card and start round number 2 of 6 rounds. The only requirement to sailing a boat is that it must have the minimum number of stones on it to sail. That number is here in the front of the boat, and it's always the same for each size boat. So all 3 size boats need at least 2 stones before they can sail. The 4s all need 3. Doesn't matter, in fact, which side you use. They're both the same. These don't have to be your stones, by the way. You can sail a boat even if you have none of your stones in it. That's another action you can do on your turn. When you sail a boat to a site, the stones on that boat are then moved from the boat to the site, and they are moved in order from front to back. So the first stone on the boat will be moved, then the second, then the third. You will ignore blank spaces if there are blank spaces. So if there are 2 stones on this and they're in positions 1 and 3, obviously the first one goes, then the next one goes, and those 2 stones move. Let's talk about what you get from these sites then. The first site up here at the top is the market. The market is a card draft, and that is going to be based on position of stones in the boat. So the first stone will get to draft 1 of these 4 cards. The next stone will get 1 of the remaining 3. And the next stone, if this boat were full, would get 1 of the remaining 2. The cards do not fill in till the beginning of the next round. We basically will wipe them and fill in 4 new cards. The cards come in 4 flavors, and I've laid out all 4 flavors. The red cards are instant, which is to say when you draft them, they happen immediately. And they are all the same in the sense that they are take a stone from the quarry and put it on one of the other sites. There are two cards for the pyramid, two cards for the temple, or no, maybe the obelisk, and two cards for the burial chamber. I can't remember which is pyramid, obelisk, burial chamber. It says very clearly on the card what they are. That's what the red cards are. They're immediate. The purple and green cards are endgame scoring, so they don't do anything when you pick them up, but they will count for you at the end of the game. The purple cards are, there's 10 of those in the deck, and they are set collect-y. So one statue is worth a point, they're triangular. Two is worth three is worth six, etc., etc. Okay? Except that anything over five is just a plus two. So if you had six of these, you would only get 17 points for that. All right? That's what those are. The green cards are also endgame scoring. They are all of the same flavor in that you're going to earn 1 point for every three stones, either in the temple, in the obelisk, or the burial chamber. I think I got that right. Again, they're all printed on the cards. Nope, there's one else with the pyramid as well. So those will vary in points depending on how many stones are on these sites at the end of the game. And last but not least are these blue cards. Blue cards are action cards. When you get a blue card, you take it and you keep it face up in front of you. And if you remember, I said there were four things you could do on your turn. The fourth thing you can do is you can, if you have a blue card, play a blue card. That is, instead of placing a stone onto a ship or taking three from the quarry or sailing a ship. The blue cards, however, are basically double actions. So what they let you do is two of the ones I just said. For example, this blue card says, take three stones from the quarry and to your supply, and then place a stone on a ship. So it's like having two actions, but you have to spend the card. The cards are one-time use. When you use them, the blue ones, they go off in the discard pile. If we need to reshuffle and use cards, we will shuffle in the discard pile. This one's a little different. This one says, sail the ship, and then you decide the order in which the stones are unloaded. We can just read these as we get them. So those are the cards, and you can shuffle those if you want.
Including the four.
Including the four. Those were just
including these example. Four.
So that's the market. The pyramids, the pyramid is built in columns from top down. So when stones come to the pyramid, they are put in column order before the next column is started. Okay? And the spaces that get covered up are instantly awarded points. So the stone that goes here gets two, the stone then that goes here gets one, the stone that goes here gets three. So here's an example of where you might want to be first or third to this pyramid, depending on if it, at the beginning of the game, if it's empty. Whereas, obviously, this is worth four if you can get there. Now, the fifth stone will not be placed in the first round because the biggest boat we have is a four. So you're angling essentially for position here as far as trying to maximize your score. Once the pyramid is full, it, of course, is built like a pyramid. So the next round, the next level of the pyramid, will be these four stones, right, that will basically go like this. Mm-hmm. And they score according to this little chart here, two, then three, then one, then three. And then the top one scores four. If there are additional stones placed here, they are placed off to the side over here, and they score 1 point each. Okay?
That's more of like a ziggurat or a step pyramid.
So that's the pyramid. The temple, so the pyramid scores points instantly when stones get placed. The temple scores at the end of every round. The temple has five spaces on it. In a three or four player game, we will be using this fifth space. And the stones get placed there in boat order from left to right. So they would just go in like, say, this. And at the end of every round, you're going to look down from above, and for every color that you see, that scores a point for each. So in this case, black would get two, and white and gray would each get a point. If three more stones came in, and they were all, let's say, all rusties, that would be one there, and then one there, and then one there. So in this case, at the end of this round, Rusty would get three, and I would get one, and Lincoln would get one. Okay? That score at the end of every round. The obelisk is a essentially fight for majority amongst the four of us. So when stones are loaded here from the boat, it doesn't matter what the order is because your color just goes to your square. And every time another one of your color goes in, you're basically just building for height. And at the end of the game, whoever has the highest in a four-player game will score 15, then 10, then 5, then 1. In order to score the one for fourth, you must have a stone there. Ties work as follows. All tied players take the number of their two or three positions, and those are totaled together and rounded. So if two people are tied for first, then they would take the points for first and second, in this case 25, and they would divide that by two, rounded against them, and they would each get 12. Hmm. All right, so that's how that works. And the burial chamber is also scored at the end of the game, not during the round. Those stones also fill in boat order, and like the pyramid, they fill in column-wise. But at the end of the game, you are going to get points for contiguous blocks of your color. And you will score for everything you have there. So for example, black will score 1 point for this one and 1 point for this one. This is also triangular. Gray has a one and a three block. This one block is worth one and the three block is worth six, so gray will score 7. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm.
So, and the same thing is true here as was true with those scoring cards, that a 5 is worth 15, but a 6 is only worth 17. It's just plus 2 for each additional. Okay. So everyone you add after that is just a plus 2. All right? That is how the burial chamber works. And that is pretty much the whole game. A weird note, you'll see this is sort of half here. The burial chamber is actually unrestricted in this direction. On the off chance that we manage to put that many stones.
We go crazy, that's all we focus on.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. The one thing that I want to point out before we start is there are always four boats every round, and there are five sites. So one site will always not be visited every round. So it is possible, for example, that the burial chamber will not be visited more than once, or maybe it'll be hit every time.
Right.
All right, we need four cards.
Absolutely.
And in case I didn't make this clear, it's per stone, not per player. So if this boat were to sail to the market, then Lincoln would get a card, then Nikki would get a card, then Lincoln would get a second card. It's one for every stone. Mm-hmm. They all operate individually in that regard.
Right. And I start.
And you are the start player.
Dun, dun, dun.
And we draw three if we draw?
If you want to draw, you draw three. Correct. You're the only one that can draw three and get three.
We'll just do that.
Makes sense. Seems like that would be a very common starting move. I will join you.
I'm the three boat.
It's a party.
It's a magic number.
I'm not going there.
Okay, Rusty.
On the three boat.
Oh, look at that. I'll join Lincoln here. Here you go, Nikki. Do you want your own boat?
Yes, I do. Ta-da.
Your own boat.
Let's move it for her someplace she doesn't
want to go. I know you could. That's
you can.
That's
you
the
totally
scary
can.
About this game. Toot, toot. I don't think they did that, though.
I didn't make this clear. I apologize. The round is over when all four boats are sailed. I forgot to say that.
Yeah, it's because then there's no more places to place.
Let's actually sail a boat.
All right. Where are we going?
We're going to go to the pyramid.
Sure. Where I'm going to get one to your five?
That's correct. It's two.
So
one.
Rusty gets two and then three. So Rusty gets five and I get one.
Okay.
Here you go, Nikki. I'll let you sail that boat wherever you want.
Why are you being so kind to me? I'm sailing.
Where are you going?
Obelisk.
Yeah.
Burr, burr, burr.
Okie doke.
And I am the second one there in that row, right?
Yep.
Yep. Look at that.
Look at that.
Oh, I don't want to miss out on any of the fun.
Party time.
I'm going to take three.
It's up to you. You can take two, Nikki.
I can take two or sail someone somewhere. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Why do I want to help anybody out?
Well, or hurt them, right?
I don't think any of the places are particularly bad right now in the first round.
This was bad for me.
Oh. I thought you wanted to go there. You
he were, didn't. He just wanted
you
to
were really jazzed about it.
I didn't know where Rusty was going.
I just wanted to be in Rusty's boat. I'm all about the
you know
Rusty
what?
Boat left.
Just give me 2 stones.
Okay.
We'll get ready for next round.
He said.
Where do you want to go, Link? What do you want 2 of? Cards, sure.
Cards. Okay. Take that.
Okay, that happens immediately.
Yep.
So read it out loud.
Paved path. Immediately place 1 stone from the quarry on your obelisk.
So you get one there.
Oh, from the quarry. That's right.
Yep.
Sweet.
Yep.
Yeah.
You.
I guess I'm going to take the lever.
The lever?
That allows me to sail a ship and choose the order in which the stones are unloaded from it.
Mm. Well, that's nice. I think that's dangerous. A really good card.
And I guess I'll take a statue since that's all that I have left to choose. So this is gone, right?
Correct. That goes to the discard pile. And these stones are removed from the ship. We should have been, in theory, spending them as we took the cards, but...
Yep.
And, I'm sorry, the statue is... You It'll collect a bunch of cards.
For each one, it's a set collecty thing. It's,
yeah, okay.
It shows the scoring on the card, right? It's the same scoring as this, as all the burial chamber.
All right.
Don't have a lot of choices. It's either the temple or the burial chamber. I think I'm going to... Go with the burial chamber right now.
Okie doke. Burp, burp. And those fill in like so.
Like so.
All right, so that ends the round. We would now score the temple. There's nothing there. We turn over a new card for the new boats. We
need the new boats.
4, a 3, a 3, and a 2. That card is removed. 4 new cards come up. And whoever would be next in turn order goes first.
2 and a 2.
And that would be me.
3, 3, 2.
3, 3, 2.
And I'm going to go here.
Oh. Place 1 stone, the blue one. Place 1 stone on a ship.
That one is place 1 stone on a ship and then sail any ship. Doesn't have to be the one you placed on.
Oh, like. An extra action on my
The blue
turn.
Cards are almost okay. always a double action. This is the only one that isn't.
All right.
And the other one is place either 2 stones on a ship or 1 stone on 2 different ships.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like a double placement.
Yeah, yeah. Sure, sure. Sure, sure. 1, 2, 3. What?
Nothing.
It's obvious what I'm thinking, so there.
Oh, I like it.
Does she? Where does she? I'm confused. Anyway.
I think I would get the bottom blue one if I sail there.
Ah, I see.
Oh, well, remember, this is just first choice.
It's first choice.
That's still not a bad move, though.
Yeah,
depending on where you want to go.
Well,
she's not necessarily the last one. Only if it fills is she the last one. She's currently right now the second cube on that ship.
Well, it doesn't mean somebody else isn't going to put something
on it. I would agree. So
and it may not go there, right?
I know.
Okay.
So if you want to change that, go for it.
I'm good.
Okay, she's good. It might help her here.
Yeah, well, she would need to be second on that one, right?
Or third.
Rosebud's lonely.
On your sled.
Yes, ooh. My sled.
I got it.
Sugar blam.
Shablam.
That's cool. Doesn't look like I know what I'm doing, but I know what I'm doing. Toot toot. I should stop doing that. It's a
I
reed.
Did it.
It's a reed boat.
Pick it up, Dave.
I want the sail. I want the sail action, please.
There you go.
Chisel. Interesting. Okay.
Victory points, please. The statue.
There you go.
Pistachio.
Pistachio.
Pick something, Nikki. Red.
May have that.
I would like the red one, please.
Okay, her stone goes here.
Why would that stone go there?
That's what the red, sorry, the red card says, immediately place one stone from the quarry, essentially, or from
into
this
the
case,
burial
above,
chamber.
Into the burial chamber.
Then I
discard. Yep.
Discard that card?
That was Lincoln's turn.
I need to get in this game. Let's go to the middle.
Oops. I'll take it from here. Otherwise, I'm cheating.
What are you thinking about?
I'm thinking I'm going where you're going.
Dang it, Dave.
I'll take three. I'll keep myself company.
Company.
Tough choices.
This is tough. Well, Rusty's gonna go there. Nikki's gonna get a boat all to herself. I'm gonna join you, Nikki.
Dang it, Dave. Both times. I am not happy about this. Shoot. I can't sail to where I want to sail.
Why not? Of course you can.
All right. Oh, gosh. This is tough.
I'll go with Rusty. I don't know where he's going. But
I think he's probably going to the pyramid, but
where am I going?
I don't know.
Burial chamber?
Stop that.
Dave.
Don't give him ideas.
That's where you should have gone. It was good for you.
It was a thought. And I tried it twice, and somebody kept blocking.
No, it wasn't blocking you. This was perfect for you. These hook, right? This would be white.
I know, but it wasn't good enough.
I mean, this is white, then you just come in this next row.
There we go.
Now I'm dead.
I'll take three stones.
Seriously?
Yep.
You're not taking me anywhere?
Nope. Go where you want. I'm giving you the choice. Go where you want.
You people.
All you've done is weaken the country.
Well, you score five if you go there, Nikki.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah. So we'll take the longboat over here. I cannot reach to place.
All right. Nikki scores five.
Two for Nikki. Four.
For Dave.
For Dave.
And then three for Nikki.
And you guys are going to the temple.
It's actually in this order.
Yeah, okay.
It matters in case anyone ever goes here again.
Well, they might. It would include other ones, right?
Right. All right, so end of round, Nikki gets a point, and I get a point. And for the next round, we need two fours, a three and a two.
Wow.
And four new cards.
And four new cards.
Four new.
Ooh, two green cards.
Three green cards.
And Lincoln did the last sale.
So I have first action.
Yep.
She's already in the lead.
I'm messing with your head.
I will go here.
Hey, why don't I move this one? Oh, no.
Yeah, of course. Boo.
Thank you for the suggestion.
Oh, excellent.
I like this idea.
I like it, too.
The burial chamber actually looks like it's right up my alley.
Yep. It's 1 point for every three at the end of the game.
Thank you.
And nice. Nikki, what would you like?
I don't know.
Okay. The temple is 1 point for every three stones in the temple. Mm. I'm guessing that will not be great. Pyramid is one for every three in the pyramid. That's already worth 2 points.
Yeah. It'll
probably be worth more. And a statue, but you don't have one already.
I don't have one. Let's take that pyramid one then.
This would be 1 point per three stones in the pyramid.
Correct. Oh, it's just anyone's stones.
Anyone's stones.
Ah.
It's all stones. Same thing for the barrow chamber. It's all stones. So that's excellent. Already worth 2 1/3 points for you.
Excellent. So how do I get that a third point?
I am going to use my sail.
You're going to set sail?
I'm going to place a stone in a ship, and then I'm going to sail it. Oh. There we go. You will be building there no more, sir.
After you got that card.
After I got that card. So, you know, that's just...
I just gave you a point.
An additional point, and I very much appreciate it.
And that got used. It goes in the discard pile.
Thank you.
Your turn, Nick.
I need to cut that 3 off. White stones, please.
Yes. There you go.
Thank you.
I thought you were going to go here instead of the cards with the boat. That's why I wanted to take you to the cards.
My sled is lonely.
I'll join Lincoln.
Nikki P?
Yep. Oh, where?
Woo!
Where are we going? Well, I'm...
You do not want to sail this one to the pyramid.
Yeah.
That will score... Oh, no, I'm sorry. That will score Rusty 3. You'll get 2. Actually, it'll be 2, 2, 3, 2.
Yeah, but I got my pyramid card.
That's true. Maybe you do
want
to do that then.
So I want a lot of pillars in there. So that's where we're going.
For some reason, I thought we were on the top level already. We're not. Okay. So 2 points for white, 1 point for gray, 3 points for rusty, 3 points for rusty. That is actually that color.
Yes.
And then 2 points for me for starting that row.
Force me to move it, or?
Oh!
3 stones?
Yeah. I mean, either one of them's fine.
Yep. I'm going to take the opportunity to fill up.
Oh, you're leaving it to Dave. That's a bad decision.
Well, I'll take 3 stones. Nikki. It doesn't matter. I just wanted to have 3 stones when we came back.
You can sail it,
or you can fill up to 5 as well.
You want to stay away from the obelisk? Here's your chance. I filled.
Yeah. Let's see. How many points is black going to get if I go to the temple there?
2.
Okay.
I'm going to get 1 anyway. You and I are going to score 1 every round until those get covered.
If I do that, then we're in the heat for obelisks. We're going for the obelisks. Burr.
All right.
That's tied for you and I, though.
Yeah, in the heat.
Dead heat. Okay.
Okay. 1 point for white and black. And for this round, 4-4-2-2. And 4 new cards. And Lincoln, it's your turn.
Oh, what the heck?
Look at that. I'm not joining people.
Yet.
Terrible, terrible choices. There.
I like it. Everybody went selfish.
Well, you get 2 on there, and then it has to set. Well, that's 3.
I like it.
Yep.
Let's see if I can make this my own personal private boat.
Private boat ho.
The answer is no.
Thank you.
Can I have 3 stones, please?
Yes, Nikki P. Oops, sorry.
Thank you.
So that would be that,
Then that, then that, then that. Oh, that's not too bad.
And then there's this other stuff that might happen too.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Don't do it. Don't you do it. Dang it, Dave. I hate you.
I'll go where Nikki goes.
I hate you.
I know that's not true.
Man. You keep brewing beautiful things for me. You just bring in the ugly. If I go there, it's gonna, but I have to do it.
Ooh.
Interesting. Look at that.
He's taking the lead.
Yep.
And causing a three-way tie. That was nice.
Shoot.
You had a lot of good places for that one. You would get the third level 4 point here if that went there.
Thought about it.
I thought that's what you might do, is move that to the pyramid just for your...
Pyramid or obelisk?
Pyramid, just for your pyramid power excitement.
Let's go there. I'm not diversifying enough.
I'm actually going to use my lever in probably the lamest way possible.
Okay.
It allows me to sail a ship and unload the cubes in any order that I want.
All right.
I'm going to go here.
Oh.
I'm going to go first.
Yeah.
And then you're going to go next.
I'm not playing well.
It's only the third round, right?
There are two more rounds.
Oh, so fourth round.
Yeah.
It's tight.
Go there, and it'll be that if I do that. All right.
Lincoln gets three. Nikki gets one. One for white.
Rusty?
Yes. Let me look over actually what's in the market. There may be things here that are useful.
It could be that you care or don't care.
1 point per three stones in the temple, not so much. At the end of the game, 1 point per three stones in the obelisk. That could be worth something.
Probably worth at least three, maybe more. You'd have to get it, though.
I would, and you're standing in my way. And that's probably why I've decided that I'm going to go to the temple.
I think that's a good play.
Agreed.
Yeah.
And what that does is it doesn't help Nikki at all.
No, it sure doesn't.
And that is it.
It was either that to me or take three stones from the quarry. 2 points for Rusty, 2 points for Black, 1 point for White. And for this, hey, all those cards go away.
Oh no.
4-3-3-3.
This is some boats.
I'm going to start the round by taking three stones. End of turn.
Three stones, please. White.
Yep.
Thank you.
Are you going to take three stones?
Maybe just one.
There we go.
And I will take three stones.
I like that sigh. I really like that sigh.
Where are we going, Lincoln?
Hmm. Oh, we've made that decision difficult now.
Leave me alone.
Never.
Well, that's arguably my best move. But I will do this instead. Here we go.
Draw three.
Interesting.
Monsters
are such interesting people. Well, I think burn in the hand. And even though it hurts Nikki a little, it does sort of help her. So Lincoln gets three. I get four. Nikki gets one. But this is technically in the pyramid.
All right, I'm sailing.
Yes?
Park it.
All right. Yeah, I figured I was losing that.
Well, Rusty, where are we going?
Depends. It depends on what you're looking for. that would be painful to me, but
I figured you're going to the cards.
Let's give this a shot.
Well,
you can go ahead and
again, you could have just taken three cubes and not gone.
True, but
leave it to Dave to choose. Oof.
I wouldn't. Yes. I'd probably just take three cubes.
I don't know. Is the statue good for Lincoln?
It's only it's only good if he gets another one next round. It's not as good as the green cards. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Put it this way. It'll be there for his third pick.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
I assume Rusty's not going to take the statue.
No. And he's keeping me from doubling up on the burial chambers.
Yeah. So do you want the chisel?
I don't think I need it. I'm going to have a hard enough time spending, although I don't know what you think.
Well, you already have a chisel, right?
Yeah, I get to displace a couple stones.
Can you cash two of those in at the same time?
No, it's one action when you take it. Mm-hmm. You might be right, Link. There might not be enough time to use them both.
Yeah, I'm going to do that. Just because I don't think I
can.
It's hard enough to do it as it is.
More importantly, if you pick up another one of those statues.
Right. And that is it.
Score. All right. 2 points for Rusty, 2 points for Black, 1 point for White, and for the final round, 4-4-2-1.
Ooh.
And Rusty, you sailed the last one?
I believe I did. To the market.
To market, to market, to be at a market. I am going to place.
Two statues.
I'm going to place one here. I feel a chisel coming on.
Well, I gotta get it out.
You gotta use it this round. Yeah. Technically, any blue cards not spent by the end of the game are worth a point.
Oh, okay.
So it is worth a point. I think using it's always probably gonna be better than the point you'll score for it, but that's so that if someone does go to the market at the end of the game.
Yeah, they get points for it.
You can still take a blue card for a point. In fact, the red cards, if there were any at the end of the game, might be really great, right? Place one on the obelisk or one in the burial chamber, or that could be huge depending on how you're set up.
Dang. Okay.
Woo! She's taking the boat.
She got her own boat. Everybody's leaving her
alone.
Yeah,
then he did that.
That hurts both of us. He could have just sailed you to the pyramid. You'd only score a point there.
Oh, he knows what I wanted to do with that boat. That boat has sailed.
That boat. This boat is clean. Where is that gonna go? It's all bad. Let's do this.
Evil.
Oh, no. I am going to take three stones.
Oh, God bless you. God bless
you. No. Rusty.
Yeah, that was bad.
That just put me in Lincoln first, though.
Put me in last on that.
Yep.
Boo! Rusty. You were supposed to sail to the obelisk.
They were both good, though, for Lincoln. If I went here, I can't let him get those statue cards, right? That would have been huge.
All right, so did you go?
Yeah, I probably threw the game, but we'll
I
see.
I need three. I can't do
it. We can sail a boat. You want to sail a boat before someone screws you on
Shows
something?
Exactly where you want to go with what's
Well, exactly where I want to go is
You actually
want.
Have an interesting place. The best place for you to go with that, believe
is
it or
the
not,
pyramid.
Is the pyramid.
Yeah. I figure.
That's actually worth an extra point to you. Yeah. So you and Rusty each score one. But you'll score an extra one for your pyramid card.
Okay. Not now or okay.
Yeah, you score right now. Look at this. Look at this disgusting display. Rusty's going to get basically place two. Hey, I'll take three stones.
And then nothing.
And then Nikki will take three stones.
Yeah.
And then Lincoln will take three stones.
He can't, no, he sails.
You can't
That's
sail.
Not legally
three.
Allowed.
Three.
And I will place my third one on the ship.
So the question is, do you want to sail that? Nah, I want to be here. Who's, oh, Lincoln goes first.
Ugh. This was the last round of
the
game.
Yeah, I got to sail it there, even though it covers me.
It's hardcore.
I got to do it. I can't let those.
Man.
I can't let those statue cards go out. Ugh. All right.
Go.
Rusty scores three. Lincoln scores one. Nikki scores one. All right, so that's all that. Okay, obelisk scoring. Lincoln is first with 15.
Yep.
The yin-yang couple over here.
Yeah.
We score 15 divided by 2, so we each get 7. Ugh. And white gets 7. Rusty gets 1.
Woo!
And for burial chamber, Lincoln has 4 singles for 4. Nikki has 3 singles for 3. Rusty has a 1 and a 3 for 7. And I have a 1 and a 4 for 11.
There we go.
I have one more for my statue, and I am officially done. Nikki has, there are 9, 10, 11, 12 in there, so she has 4 points for her pyramid. Lincoln, you have 3 points for the car for the statues, right?
Yeah.
And how many for that? Which one is that?
That one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points.
Yeah.
Oh. Ooh.
I will also receive 5 for that, and 5 for the obelisk as well. Oh, so close.
We also have the same amount of stones.
I think it's stones. I think it is stones and sled.
Nice.
The tiebreaker, if players are tied, is whoever has most stones on sled. You and I each have 3. The next tiebreaker isn't, so we share the victory.
Yay.
Aw, love.
There you go. I mean, I kind of helped him there, right? I mean, I helped me, too, because I was in fourth.
Right.
I went from fourth
That's
to sharing.
That's what I was kind of...
I went from fourth to sharing second, and obviously I was never doing any math, so I wasn't looking at your cards to see how far you would catch
but
up.
But this would have been horrible if you let me get that, because that's 10 points, or 6 points.
Well, but...
But if I got both...
But no, but it's in lieu of this, right?
Right.
You got 15 there.
Right.
But you were probably going to pick up 5, so, I mean, it's in a weird way, it's the same 10 points. I helped me, though.
Right. Well, I was... That was going to sail.
More importantly, I gave myself a chance to win by making sure Rusty was fourth because those two bonus cards were going to be big.
Right.
He had, in my mind, he had anywhere from 8 to 11 points in front of him in cards. So he was never as far back as he looked on the scoring track. So, what do you think, Nikki P?
I enjoy it. There's a lot more, like, you know, going on in this game than you would think. A lot more thinky, a lot more... the funny thing is I was just sitting here thinking, what am I going to say? You know that whole, like, the betting and valuing your thing?
On auctions?
In auction games. Mm-hmm. This kind of has that as far as when do I sail, when do I not sail. So, clearly... Again,
not
so
off.
Good at that.
You're right. Really not that far off. You're 6 points behind the leader.
But there was some points
Yeah, but Lincoln's right. The scoring to me in this game is a little deceptive because any two boat switches could could.
He's shifting empty boats.
I am. Any two boat switches could change the scoring enough so that you're now in first and I'm now in last. But it's not like you needed to find five more points somewhere. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but I feel like there were a couple times where I just didn't value what you guys. I didn't see what you were gonna gun for.
Right.
Which is the same in an auction game, right?
Yep.
So there were several times, but if I had at least caught one of the times where I should have just sailed it, I think I would have at least closed that gap a little bit. So, but that in a way that makes it kind of the fun and push your luck of it anyways, right?
Right.
So.
One of the things I was trying to do, and I never really seemed to get it done, was I was trying to diversify in the boats so that regardless of where they went, I was at least involved in two or three different items going on.
Right.
Even though it looked like I was stacking up on one boat, I was trying for one strategy where I was trying to get into the burial chamber and build up a nice collection until Dave tore me down. But I started realizing that focusing on one thing, on one boat, was harming me because somebody else had control over that. I couldn't.
Potentially, yes.
Yeah, potentially, because I'd place a cube, the next person can just take that boat from me, and I'm like, no, that's not where I wanted it to go.
Well, it's interesting you say that. This is the third time now I've played this game,
right.
And I decided before we started I was going to try a strategy that, of course, I abandoned halfway through.
What was it that you were
thinking? I was going to never ship a boat and see if I could win that way. The problem was I ended up getting cards that allowed me to do stuff with shipping boats. So
right.
Once that happened, I couldn't not do it. But the other two times I played, I always felt like if I could get someone else to ship my cubes for me, then I would save turns. You had two turns in which you shipped a boat and you had one cube on your sled. And in both of those cases, neither one of the two choices were really that important to you. And I think had you taken cubes and forced me to do the sled,
you might have
won this game because you were not that far behind.
But that's why I did a lot of that.
Right.
You know what I mean? I didn't do it all the time, but I was specific, or I'd send somebody early, you know, because you think, oh, hey, it's just going to get that one out of the way.
Right.
And, you know, because when it's like one or two,
right,
those are kind of frustrating.
Right.
Because you're like, where are those going?
Right.
So you sometimes want to go, just send them someplace that's not going to do any good, really.
Well, and the fun part is the minimum requirement, right?
Yeah.
I mean, at one point, you and I each were like, well, I'm going to,
I can't move that boat yet.
Because
it is weird. Yeah. It's not terribly clear on there, but it is.
Right.
It's
well,
just
what's nice is they're
eyes.
All the same.
Yeah.
Now that you know, a four is always a three.
Right.
You never
it's always, you know, it's just one less unless it's that boat can go empty, I guess. But
but what did you think of the game?
Oh, I really like this game. I think it has like a classic feel to it. But with the boats placing and determining, like, is it time for that to sail? Is it time for me to draw more cubes? I actually thought about, I mean, ultimately it's good that I got more cubes because, you know, I was forced to, right? Because
right, so as was I.
Yeah, it ended up tying the game for us. But it's interesting. I really love, there is a lot of choice in the few choices that you have.
Well, again, this is the thing that I do like the most about this is you only do one thing on your turn.
Right.
You really only do one of three things on your turn because you might never get a blue card for the whole game.
Right.
And it's really just the when do I pull the trigger, and like I said, from the beginning I was going to do the I'm going to try not to sail strategy, and I already failed at that by positioning myself right away so that you were able to score 5 points to my one in the pyramid.
Right.
I mean, I just, again, I wasn't looking ahead. I'm like, oh, I'll just join this boat. Thinking, I'll join these boats, I'll never sail them. But what I should have done was, because that was a three or a four, I think. And what I should have done was I should have joined the back of that boat. So that if someone else placed in there, I'd be at least okay for the pyramid. Mm. So the trick to my strategy was I needed to set myself up better to be essentially on every island. I feel like the temple gets the least amount of love.
Yeah, I think that only starts to happen if somebody gets a card that changes that, right?
Even then, it seems like that would be the card you would draw the least. It, as I said, I've played three times now. This is the most number of stones I've seen in a temple.
What do you think, Rusty?
I actually had a round where I was trying to position myself so that I could get another two here. But that boat got sailed.
Ah.
That boat got pulled out from underneath me. And I didn't want to
I think, wasn't it this one? I saw that was where that was going. I'm like, that's not happening. Because I was like, it's going to be good for me, and that was the splitting of the vote. You know, it was where it was a three-way tie plus me in the lead, right?
Well, let me tell you where the temple does get some love.
Is on the other side?
Yes. So each of these cards is actually double, these sites is actually double-sided.
Okay.
So let's turn them all over, and I will explain what the other sides do.
Dup, dup, dup.
The other sides are considered the advanced sides, though, to be honest with you, they don't feel any more advanced to me than the other sides, than the original side. So in this case, the market is face up, face up, face up, two face down.
Ooh.
If you draw the two face down, you keep one of them only, but you don't know what they are.
Right.
So that could be great, or it could be they're terrible for you. All right? This pyramids, there are three pyramids, and when the boat goes, whoever moves their cube can decide where they want that to go. So if this were to sail, Nikki could say, I want to start this one. And if you wanted to, Rusty, you could go second on hers, or you could start one of the others. You don't have to be in the pyramid she started. Hmm. All right? Yeah. These pyramids only have one topper. That topper is also worth four. But
they're misshapen pyramids.
But this square is a point plus a blind card
Ooh.
From the top of the deck. Oh. This is a point plus three cubes from the quarry onto your sled.
Nice.
This is a point plus take a cube, I think from the quarry, I'm not sure if it's on your sled, and it immediately goes onto a boat. That sounds great, but we played one game with this side, and this never happened because this was almost always the second to last or last boat sailed, or by the time the boats got sailed to here, they were all full. So this was never able to be used. Here's where the temple gets love. So if this were filled like this, and I'm kind of covering the spaces, I'll do them below. Imagine this with the temple. Black can take a point or two cubes.
Mm.
Rusty, in this case, would take 2 points. Gray can take a point or two cubes. White just takes a card blind from the deck. And again, 1 point or two cubes. So this temple got a lot more love, as you might suspect. In fact, we played with Aaron, actually, and let's assume Aaron was Rusty's color in this case. Aaron positioned himself early this way. So he was always able to get, or maybe it was this way. So he was always able to get four cubes and a card if he wanted. And interestingly enough, he came in dead last. And the reason that he did was he was so protective of this that any chance he got to sail a single boat or a single cube to the temple so that no one could cover him, he did.
Right.
And he focused on something.
I think had he ignored that. He also drew a bad card blind almost every time. Like he got the temple bonus, he got a statue when he had none. He got like an immediate red card that was like add a stone to somewhere, the obelisk that didn't help him.
Right.
Well, it helped him a little bit, but this obelisk is just when your stones arrive, your first stone goes here, your second stone goes here, and when you have a third of your color, they go on the first available slot, and you get 10 points, then 9, then 8, then 7, then 6, then 5. So there's no majority fight or race, but two stones here scores you nothing.
Right.
Okay.
So the effort to get two of your stones there might be completely worthless to you. Hmm. So it's more of like a race. I thought this was also more interesting to me than the fight to...
It's just different to
me. It is. And then this burial chamber doesn't work on the contiguous stuff. It just still fills in columns. And at the end, each of the three rows pays out by majorities. Most stones in this row, 8, then 4, then 3, then 0, with the same thing, which is ties are the two scores are, or the three scores are added together and divided by number of players. So that was also interesting because being in any row was good here. Obviously, getting an extra stone in a top row was better. Well, that's
can you flip them over and have A, B, A, B or whatever?
Yeah, I'm sure you can. There's nothing in the rules that say.
Were you going to ask that?
Yeah.
So in this case, Rusty would score 8. Nikki is second and she would score 4 for just that one stone. So if Lincoln and I never got into this side, go ahead.
No, it's okay. Go ahead and finish.
No, that was basically it. I found that these sides
felt a little more interesting to me.
Right.
What was nice about the burial chamber on this side was it was simpler.
Right.
Not that the scoring is that complicated. Once you get the idea that you're just trying to build clumps, that's not hard to see. But I liked that, and I liked that this temple was sexier. It got a lot more action.
But to me, the advanced burial chamber feels like three obelisks. If you think about it that way, you're building three different obelisks. Whoever has the most, you've got three different obelisks, but a little less control over that. You have to position it on the boat in the right order to get into each of those obelisk fights.
This gives you an interesting choice, though, right? Which is Nikki is white, so if she can keep... If she can keep, in this case, Lincoln and I out of this row, that one cube scores her four. So it's to her advantage in a weird way almost to give you a third one there if she can and let you keep your majority. You're still scoring the same eight.
Right.
As opposed to if an obelisk happened, I know what you're saying. Go ahead.
Just, Rusty, you're the only one who hasn't played this before. How do you feel about it?
I like it. I looked at it first when we sat down, and I wasn't sure that it was going to have enough depth to it, that there weren't going to be enough choices on it. And my first playthrough, I, of course, wasn't playing optimally, but I can see that tension of, you know, okay, I want to go here, I want to do this, and now I have to wait a full round and hope nobody takes over that boat, fills in behind me, and I like that. I like that tension, but I also like the speed at which it plays. It's a fast game.
Yeah.
It's not something that's going to take 2 or 3 hours. We can play this again quickly. We can change it up.
Yep.
So it's a definite something I need to add to my collection.
Oh.
Yeah, it's coming. It's due, or actually it might already be out. It might have been out at Origins. Go ahead.
Was it?
I think so.
I don't remember.
I mean, people were buying it, but I don't know if it was officially out.
Yeah.
They rushed it. They pushed the release date up because of the nomination.
You did that ooh like that was impressive. Doesn't Rusty's collection huge? Doesn't Rusty add everything to his collection?
That ooh add to my collection vote.
Don't you add everything to your collection?
No, not at all.
Just sounds like a very important thing.
More than 500?
Well, if you're talking base games,
more than 500 and you don't answer right away, the answer is yes.
About 450, I think, base games. You get expansions, all right. Promos.
All right.
Well, cool.
Wow.
Well, thanks for teaching us, Dave.
You're welcome, Lincoln.